You may be seated. Today is Sunday, and once again we are privileged to come together in the warmth and the fellowship of the house of our Lord. I think this morning all of our thoughts are with our Reverend Fordwick and his bride, Rosemary, as they start their new life together. And I'm sure that our prayers are with them also, that their new life may be a happy one. What does a young man know? And how does a young man learn? I don't have to remind you all that I am not a minister. And to many of you, what I have to say this morning will not seem like a real sermon. But Reverend Fordwick asked me to be here in his absence and to speak to you, so I'm going to try. While I was preparing to speak with you this week, I learned things that I did not know before, and I was reminded of some things that I had forgotten or at least misplaced for a time. And I would like to share these things with you. I learned some of the many different ways that people have of worshiping God. And I think I learned that everybody, in his own way, has a different way. Now, I don't know the Bible as well as most of you, and I'm sure that all of you in here could quote me back chapter and verse to prove your belief, which I might not be able to do. But I'll bet that if we really looked into it, we'd find that each of your beliefs is in some way different and special from everybody else's, just as you all as people are different and special from everybody else. Now, I go to college. I'm a college man, and I tend to read a lot of books, and I tend to feel that the answers are going to be in the books. So I went to college this week, and I took out a lot of big, heavy books, and I looked through them, and I looked for the answer. And I found a lot of answers. I didn't find the answer. But I also found an answer in an afternoon walk with my grandfather on the mountain. Now, he told me that God is everywhere, all the time, and that all we really have to do is just acknowledge that and listen. I spoke with my grandmother, who knows her gospel, and she knows the right of it, and she knows the wrong of it in her own special way. And she is a fine woman. This week, I didn't have too much chance to talk with my mother because she was busy herself, and she had things of her own to do. But I watched her. And I found out that the Lord guides her in her footsteps in ways that are unique to her and in ways that make her different from everybody. Whether it's the way she tends a sick baby or the way she chooses to conduct her class at school. This week I looked over the shoulder of my younger brother and I saw these words that he had written about our father. You can always go to him and ask and get an answer. Now, you all know John Walton, our father. Now, you don't necessarily know him from seeing him in church every Sunday, but let me tell you that what Jim Bob said is right. You can always go to him and ask and get an answer. And he is always there for us. And just as he has his special way of being with his family and giving them his answers, he also has a special way of being with his God and getting answers from his God. We are all blessed by our families and by our loving friends who help us and who give us support. And we can be daily examples to each other and nourish each other and help each other in spite of our differences and also many times because of them. Just as my earthly father is always with his family, so our Father in heaven is always with his family, which embraces all of mankind. And it seems to me I've learned this week that our Lord must be very, very great indeed to be able to encompass so many different kinds of feelings and so many different kinds of people in his everlasting love.